So we've all heard the phrase, less is more. That is truly the case when it comes to capturing the attention span of people, especially business people.
Joe McCormack is trying to help us be brief, and he tackles the topic in his book, Brief, Make a Bigger Impact by Saying Less. Joe joins us now. Great to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
I love this topic. Why is it that we're so consumed, we don't have time to get through emails or listen to a sales pitch?
We live in an information age, so there's the amount of information that people have to consume on a daily basis is overwhelming. People are flooded with information. So the averages are 300 emails a week. People are getting cell phones, smartphones. They're checking their devices constantly. They're glued to their phone, right? So brevity is the way for people to break through. So people's attention spans are dropping like a rock. The average a decade ago, 12 seconds. Today, 8 seconds.
Good gosh. What does the acronym BRIEF mean?
It stands for background, reason, information, ending, and follow-up. So if you think about like a typical conversation a person would have with their boss, what's the background? When was the last time we talked? Refresh my memory, give me some context. The reason, why am I talking to you about this right now? People often leave out the why. So you're wondering, okay, what was this meeting about? Information, what are the three bullet points, the three key ideas that we want to cover in this conversation? Ending, when is this going to end? People don't naturally end, they keep on talking forever.
Yeah.
They need to figure out where is it going to end? And then follow up, is there any follow up things that you want me to do? So that was an acronym to organize or structure a business communication, like meetings and things like that, to make it easier for people.
There are serious consequences when we can't be brief, aren't there?
Yeah, think about like an entrepreneur. Somebody's got a big idea. Their moment of truth comes and they've got to pitch this idea or share it with somebody, a decision maker. What's happening with that decision maker is fascinating. They have the mental ability to process 750 words a minute, but I can only speak 150 words a minute. So there's 600 extra words floating around their head. They call that the elusive 600, right? So I have to manage that inattention. That person, when I'm talking to them too long, those 600 words will start thinking like, when is this going to be over? I don't understand what they're talking about. So your responsibility in brevity is to manage those precious moments they have with that person so that in and out, they get it and they know what to do with it. So they're not wondering, okay, what is this conversation about? And that often happens in business today.
How does somebody get started? What if someone's really long-winded? How do they take the first step?
The first step is awareness, right? The awareness is that this is a problem. People are drowning in information. It's not about you, it's about them, right? So the people are really having a hard time. Don't push them under. Okay, so long conversations make it hard for people. Keep them short. So that's the first thing, is be aware. The second thing is be disciplined, right? So if I'm going to write an email, take time to trim things in that email. So when the person opens it up, they get it quickly. They scan it and they know the point of the email. Or if there's a meeting, you take time to prepare in advance what the meeting's going to be about. And the third thing is be decisive. So when you're decisive, there's a time and a place for long conversations. Right, so the brief is not about saying all conversations should be short, but there is a time and a place for short ones. Meetings, progress reports, interviewing is a perfect one. Right? People get nervous, they talk too much. Know when you need to be brief and be ready for those moments.
How long is your book?
The book is 250 pages, right? So my running joke is I got paid by the word, which isn't true, but the old habits die hard, right? So the book is structured in parts where we talk about why brevity is important, how to be brief, so there's specific techniques that professionals can use. And then the third section is when and where to be brief. So you can isolate those moments, progress reports for your boss, emails, meetings, presentations, where you need to use this muscle. And this is a muscle that everybody needs to use. This isn't just for people that are long-winded. All professionals, this is an essential for business today. So if you want to survive and you and your ideas stand out, brevity is your weapon.
Gosh, this is great information.
It really
is. Eye-opening. So true. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much.
The book is called Brief.
Oh. And thank you so much for joining us. I'm going to be brief and just say, go to our website.
Thank you.
My
Carolina.
Carolina Today, if you missed anything.
That was pretty brief.
Yeah. Bye. That was brief?
Yeah.
Not goodbye. Bye.